I came during my childhood here to Delhi to study. I'm originally from the city of Amritsar in Punjab. My parents live there. They got my admission done in National Association for the Blind, and it's among the very few institutes in the country which sends students to mainstream schools and provide them only with resource teaching. It's not about other people adjusting and accepting, it's about me understanding my own disability. Say during kindergarten and all, I myself used to find a lot of difficulty in explaining to others what I want from them. The later part it became easier because I knew how to ask for what I need.
Hello. Yeah, good morning. This is Sonali calling from Delhi office. Bahari, are you on field?
See, if I can't do something which others can, well, you can't call it abnormal. Abnormal for me would be something out of the ordinary. It's not out of the ordinary. If I am disabled, I'm sure there are like lakhs of other people who are disabled and who can't do the same thing. So how is it abnormal?
नाम है मेरा कांति सागर और एज है 34 और आई एम स्टेइंग इन कालका जी सिंस 1979. तो मुझे पोलियो हुआ था एक साल की उम्र में, तो मेरे पापा मम्मी यहाँ लेकर आए मुझे और उस टाइम पर उन्होंने ट्रीटमेंट दिलाया.
मैंने बहुत टाइम से पापा को कह रही थी, पापा आई वांट टू गो शिरडी. 2011 में मैंने पापा से बोला, मैंने कहा पापा चलते हैं मम्मी और आप. पापा कहते नहीं मैं कहीं नहीं जाना चाहता. मैंने कहा मम्मी आप चलो. नहीं तुम दोनों फीमेल्स को अकेले नहीं जाने दूँगा. आई प्लान विद माई यंगर ब्रदर. मैंने उसको बोला छोटू तुम चलो मेरे साथ. ऐसा नहीं कि गर्ल नहीं करेगी, उसी क्या नाल छोटू वुमेन्स ही. हाँ ठीक है हम चलने के लिए तैयार हैं. हम कुफरी गए थे जहाँ पर घोड़े पे बैठना बहुत बड़ा टास्क था. वो मेन सब लोग कहते हैं नॉर्मल लोग गिर जाते हैं, तुम तो ऐसे ही गिर जाओगी. इनके नहीं मम्मी मैं बैलेंस बनाती हूँ.
दिस इज बिफोर कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग पोलियो. This is when you were about
two and a half years.
You same picture. बिल्ली पकड़ी हुई है मैंने ये मेरी टेंथ के आई कार्ड पे बोर्ड्स के कार्ड पे ले ली थी हाँ जी मम्मी खोलना मत
अच्छा मैंने पानी में भी लाऊं
नहीं नहीं वो ना गिर जाएगी लाइट आ गई ये व्हेन आई वाज इन 12th स्टैंडर्ड ये जब मेरा स्पाइन का ऑपरेशन हुआ था प्लास्टर में हुआ अंदर तो आई यूज्ड टू प्ले दिस बेंजो लड़का लग रही हूँ ना देख
खुश लग रही हो
खुश तो मैं हमेशा रहती हूँ
आई एम कैथेट साइना करेंटली आई वेंट टू एनआईटी एंड नाउ आई एम इन दिल्ली बेसिकली परस्यूइंग अ जॉब When I was tired and I used to play with Timin, one car got very fatty to one day. We were a tiny kid, maybe about 7, 8. And she told me, Natasha, when will you get cured of your deafness? When will the disease get over? And I had to explain to her that I'm not a disease and I'm going to be deaf forever. I remember that. That was funny for me. Some people have asked me, like, do you feel bad about it? Sometimes I do. But I can't think about it every day. Because that would just spoil the quality of my life.
I was 12, 11 and a half actually, when something wet, unusual, trickled down my leg. My fingers, they told me something was different. I touched it, intrigued, playing with it, letting the wetness run down my fingers. Taking in that unfamiliar smell, trying to find parallels with anything in my deaf-blind world. What are you doing? It's dirty. Now, don't get scared. It's going to happen every month. But don't touch it. Dirty? But, Ma, I want to know more. But I believed you, Ma. I believed it was dirty.
Wall is the opening and it opens only on one side. So from the right ventricle, the impure blood goes to the lungs. And it is taken by pulmonary arteries.
My father used to tell me, "Tumhare liye ya padhai hai ya dawai hai." I contracted polio when I was 3 years old, so I had to be rehabilitated back into life. I could not go to school because of my treatment and rehabilitation and all, so I started going to school from 9th standard. 9th to 12th, I did a regular schooling in Cambridge Foundation, Rajouri Garden. Then after that, I did my graduation from Delhi University through distance mode. And then I did my MA Economics through distance mode from Punjab University. MA English from Annamalai, again through distance mode. And MSc Psychotherapy Counseling from Nagaland University. So every degree, I got it from distance mode. My parents knew I had little interaction with the outside world. Social life was negligible. Information was not much available. Jitna mummy batati thi, us zamane mein jaise sab ladkiyon ko mummy batati thi, वैसे मुझे भी मम्मी बताया करती थी कुछ ऐसा स्पेशल इन्फॉर्मेशन, क्योंकि तब इंटरनेट और कुछ ऐसा रीडिंग में दोज काइंड ऑफ टॉक्स वर अ टैबू इन आर सोसाइटी इन दोज डेज. अब थोड़ा सा ओपन हो गया कि गर्ल्स गो आउट देमसेल्व्स टू गेट देयर सैनिटरी पैड्स एंड ऑल. हमारे टाइम पे तो नाम लेना भी मतलब कुछ बहुत ख़राब बात है. If I go to a gynecologist for my checkups, चार वार्ड बॉयज़ आएंगे, दो मेरे को कंधे से उठाएंगे, दो मुझे पाँव से उठाएंगे जैसे कि मैं आटे की बोरी हूँ, और मुझे उठाकर बेड पे रखेंगे. मेरा दुपट्टा कहाँ जा रहा है, मेरे कपड़े कहाँ जा रहे हैं, दे वोंट केयर. इवन द डॉक्टर्स वोंट केयर बिकॉज आई एम अ ह्यूमन बॉडी, आई एम नॉट अ ह्यूमन बींग, आई एम नॉट अ फीमेल विद माई ओन डिग्निटी, सो दे वोंट केयर. तो इसलिए मैं कहती हूँ कि जो हेल्थ फैसिलिटी स्पेशली फॉर द फीमेल, अब अगर कैपिटल रीजन में यह हाल है तो रूरल एरियाज में तो आई डोंट नो व्हाट वुड बी देयर. अ पर्सन विद डिसेबिलिटी मोस्टली नीड्स अ लिसनर. काउंसलर्स आर आई थिंक मस्ट टू गाइड देम, टू लिसन टू देम. आई प्रोवाइड देम विद काउंसलिंग सर्विसेज. आई ट्राई टू गिव देम काउंसलिंग ऑनलाइन, टेली काउंसलिंग थ्रू मेल्स एंड ऑल. पेरेंट्स दे इम्पोज, राइट. सोसाइटी इट हैज़ इट्स ओन परसेप्शंस. उन्होंने अपना अलग सोच के रखा हुआ है. मम्मी पापा जो बोलेंगे वो करना है, स्कूल में टीचर ने जो बोला वो करना है. सो मोस्टली व्हाट हैपन्स, देयर इज़ नोबडी टू हूम वी कैन टॉक अप.
हम लोग पांच बहन भाई थे, तो मेरे पापा ज़्यादातर इम्पोर्टेंस देते थे बेटों को. यूपी माइंड थे पापा. अब बड़ी लड़की हो गई है, इस उम्र में लड़कियाँ ज़्यादा बड़ी हो जाती हैं, शादियाँ नहीं होती हैं, लड़के अच्छे नहीं मिलते हैं, तो रिस्पॉन्सेस आना शुरू हो गए थे मेरे लिए. तो मुझे बहुत गुस्सा आया इनके पापा. मैंने तो अभी स्टार्टिंग की है और तुम तो मेरी शादी की बातें कर रहे हो. मैं इतनी मेहनत से जो मैं स्कूल जा रही हूँ, इतना बैग उठा के बोझा. मेरी बहन मेरी हेल्प करती थी, मेरे से बैग नहीं उठता था. मेरी यंगर सिस्टर दो दो बैग कैरी करके जाती थी मेरे साथ. तो ये मेहनत बेकार जाएगी पापा, मुझे पढ़ने दो. आई वॉन्ट टू मतलब मैं स्टडी करना चाहती हूँ. इतने साल ऐसे ही नहीं हुआ, तो रोटी पकानी थी तो पढ़ाया क्यों, मुझे तो ऐसे ही पका लेती रहते हैं. लोगों का कमेंट होता है मेरे लिए कि कोई डिसेबल है, हैंडीकैप, इनके पास नौकरियाँ, हमारे पास नौकरियाँ नहीं. स्कूल में एम ए स्कूल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, एज ए कंप्यूटर ऑपरेटर, एज दिस माई डेजिग्नेशन. एक्चुअली मुझे लगता है बहुत मिस कर रही हूँ मैं, स्कूल नहीं जा रही हूँ. तो हाउस में मैं कुछ भी नहीं हूँ, मुझे लगता है मैं जीरो बन गई हूँ, मैं कुछ कर ही नहीं पा रही हूँ. एटलीस्ट वो जो मेरा स्ट्रेंथ है मैं बाहर दिखा पाती हूँ, मैं कुछ कर पाती हूँ, तो मैं हैप्पी विद दिस वर्ल्ड. मम्मी इज़ डिपेंडेंट ऑन मी. तीन बेटे हैं मम्मी के पास, तीनों बेटों में से उतना हक किसी पे नहीं जमाती है जितना कांति आएगी. कांति विल डू सो एंड सो वर्क. तो कांति मेरे लिए पहले से ही फोन आ जाता है, कांति सीधा यहाँ पर आना, मैं यहाँ पर होंगी और यहाँ से मुझे लिख के जाना. संडे वाले दिन एक दिन बैठ कर मम्मी को लेके जाती हूँ, सारा राशन का सामान उसमें डाल के. मेरे लिए मेरा स्कूटी लाइक एवरीथिंग, माय लाइफ. आई फील जैसे कि मैं इसमें चढ़ गई हूँ तो बस मुझे अच्छी जगह पहुँचा ही देगा, ये सब है. सो आई फील वेरी इजी विद दिस स्कूटी. और मेरी संगी साथी से बोलते हैं वो बन चुकी है, और इसके बिना मैं अकेलापन फील करती हूँ.
So basically when I thought of conversation, I look at the person's lips and I see how the lips move and where the tongue is going and all that. So that tells me how things are verbalized. So even with hearing deaf children, a lot of people can't follow them because the sound is not very clear. But I can follow them because their lips are perfect. The lip movement is perfect. So I'm not listening so much to the sound. I'm listening a bit, but the lip movement tells me more. So that is how I communicated in school. And but the teacher did not understand that. And often while teaching, she would turn around or she would cover her mouth with the book. And then I could not understand anything. So that was why she thought that she got very confused of why am I understanding half the time and not understanding half the time. So then the PT started. The teacher thought that because I could speak and communicate with people in a so-called normal way, I was pretending to be deaf for attention or sympathy. And then my mom found out through another person what was happening, and she took me out. I was 6 years old when I was told about sick. My sister was there, I was sick. My parents sat down with us and thought of the whole thing. But as I grew up, I became a little more curious because I forgot something. So then I got a book and I read. So it was kind of very in perspective. Society makes sex seem like, ooh, drama, you make a whole drama about it. It's one of the things of life, beautiful and lovely, but one of the things.
You are informed about all this, but not like, say, sex education course. Only those surface level information you get during biology. Nothing more and nothing less than that. Maybe through movies and through chat with your seniors and all, you find out a lot of things, I guess. So, yeah, and then, okay, you maybe read one or two MBs as you grow up because you want to know how they are. Why are people so crazy about them? When you can't see, you always perceive yourself with what others tell you about you. If somebody says, you know, you look beautiful wearing this color, or you're beautiful in general, or, you know, you have a fair complexion, then you have to agree that you have a fair complexion. Say, now I put on little weight, but when I was slimmer, they used to say to you, you're really smart. So I used to think, yeah, I'm really smart. I used to think, I of myself. So it's always that, or it's in terms of the colors I wear. If you say you look good in white, or you look good in black, then I would, when I go shopping, I'll keep that in mind, and I'll buy things with you know, which are in white or black color. So to some extent, yeah, it's this. And then over the years, you know, when with all these notions in your subconscious or unconscious, whatever is the right term, mind, you begin to develop an image of yourself.
Wanted to be the lingerie model. The one in magazines, on TV and the internet. But her body was always different from mine. Taller, skinnier. So complete. I couldn't look like her. My body was different. A body that found expression only in demons and witches with disfigured faces and upturned feet? Passions, find the sexy in you, the tagline read. And just then, I noticed that strap resting confidently on my shoulder. And I realized that lingerie didn't need her body to look sexy. And I didn't need to look like her.
I guess when I just dress well, I feel big, or if I exercise, then I feel really good. When I'm out of the shower, you know, simple stuff like that. When I want to dress up, I dress up, irrespective of whether that's the person I want to impress or not. I used to dress up more for other people, but now I just dress up for myself. And if there's somebody there, I'm really happy if you appreciate me and my sexiness. But I feel sexy anyway, whether or not there's somebody there. At first glance, people definitely, I think they find me attractive. But attention goes down when people find out about the hearing impairment. That is okay for me because I want someone who's substantial, you know, who's not turned up by this thing. When you look at me or anyone who has deafness and just that, they seem like any other person with a perfectly working body, but we're not. So for people, it came as a bit of a shock when I told them or somebody else told them about my deafness, because they will tell me that, oh, you seem so normal. And I'd be like, what did you expect? Like when you go to the toilet and you see the sign for a man and for a woman, it's like full body. If you see, he's got the full flesh. His arm and his stomach and his legs, they're all proportionate. His head is proportionate to his body. But if you see the wheelchair, the man in the wheelchair, he looks like funny too. The edges are very sharp as opposed to this, where the edges are rounded. What I prefer personally is this icon by Nathaniel Sidwell. It depicts a man on a wheelchair and he's very proportionate. And his arms are right at the proper place. And it's all rounded. And the wheel is separate from the man. I like that. So when you see that, you feel that it is a human, a man in his own right. When you see that, you feel, it does not feel like a person. People with a handicap tend to be desexualized. And this is a very good example of that. Because when you see toilet sign, there's a man and there's wheelchair accessible. There's a woman and there's wheelchair accessible. But you cannot make out whether the person on the wheelchair is a man or a woman. And that is a self-sure. How society desexualizes it. It's right there in our emotions in so many ways. I mean, just don't question it.
And finally, can we have some guesses? What was that again? Okay, let's see.
Even in Barfi movie, maybe a limit tak infantilization dikhai gayi. इन्फेंटलाइजेशन इज बाय द मीन्स कि वो जो लड़की जिसे ऑटिज्म है उसको हमेशा बच्चों के जैसे कपड़े पहना के रखे हैं, पिंक रिबन, पिंक फ्रॉक्स. वाई वांट पीपल विद डिसेबिलिटी, स्पेशली ऑटिस्टिक चिल्ड्रन, शोन एज अडल्ट्स. वो हमेशा बच्चे तो नहीं रहेंगे ना, कभी तो बड़े होंगे, तो बड़े में उनको कोई रोल मॉडल ही नहीं मिलता. हमेशा बच्चा बच्चा बना के रखते हैं.
I am overprotected till now and they try to over-infantilize me till now. Sometimes our male friends, which we meet, they are also seen with suspicion. Abhi, I'm trying to break my chains, but still, because I respect them, so sometimes I don't overdo it. I don't rebel. Two extremes. Either the pitiable side of disability or the superhuman side of disability. So the human angle is always missing. हम भी उसी तरह से काम करते हैं जैसे सब करते हैं. Same emotions, same desires, everything is same. What are we applauded for? Just for existing. फिर ले आया दिल मजबूर क्या कीजिए. I love myself. I admire myself. I smile at myself. कोई नहीं होता, मैं खुद को smile देकर देखती हूँ. और बहुत अच्छा लगता है. आप भी ट्राई करके देखो, खुद को स्माइल करो, बहुत अच्छा लगेगा. यू विल फील गुड अबाउट योर सेल्फ. तो आई जस्ट लव माई सेल्फ. आई लव गेटिंग रेडी. पूरा उसी तरह से मेकअप करना. और देर इज़ नो हार्म इन इट. एवरीबॉडी शुड. इंडिया में अगर मैं इस समय कहीं किसी ब्यूटी पार्लर में चले जाऊँ तो सब लोग मुझे घूम घूम के ज़रूर देखेंगे कि ये क्यों आई है, इसको क्या ज़रूरत. क्यों नहीं ज़रूरत भाई, मेरी मर्जी. Patient with spina bifida has latex allergy. Quite possible. More than 50% of the patients with spina bifida have latex allergy. But the general physicians, they might not be knowing to tell him not to use condoms because he may develop a very serious latex allergy because of it. The word SEX is a taboo in our society. For females especially, it is a double term because on the basis of gender and on the basis of abilities of their body. Sexuality for me is different from sex. Sexuality is the complete being, our complete being, what we are, how we carry again, how we touch, how we see. We can't separate it from our body. We can't separate it from our disabilities. Sexuality is a part of every human being. We have the right to express our sexuality. I am a woman. I should express myself. Why shouldn't I? Suppose if I go to a party, either I am a baby there, सब लोग आंटियाँ आएंगी, मेरे सर पे हाथ फेरेंगी, मेरे बाल खराब कर देंगी, मेरा सारा हेयर स्टाइल खराब कर देंगी, जब भी पापा के प्यार करेंगी, बहुत गुस्सा आता था. क्यों? मतलब मेरी एज की मेरी कज़न है, अगर शी इज़ ऑल्सो 45 ईयर्स ओल्ड, उसको तो तुम ऐसा नहीं कर रहा, तो मुझे क्यों? इफ देर आर मेन, दे फाइंड मी वेरी अट्रैक्टिव बिकॉज आई एम अ होल पैकेज. दे फाइंड मी टू बी इंडिपेंडेंट, गुड एजुकेशन, आई लुक ब्यूटिफुल, आई नो आई लुक ब्यूटिफुल. आई थिंक मैं ही शायद कहीं पर कमी हो जाती है कि मैं उनके सामने उनको बच्चा दिखती हूँ और इनके सामने इनको हद से ज़्यादा अच्छी दिखती हूँ. तो दोनों चीज़ें तो पॉसिबल नहीं हो सकती है ना मेरे साथ.
Last night, we went on. Your sweet, soft breath on that jutting stump I'd never accepted. Magic was when I felt you. Your hair, your warm skin. Magic was knowing that it felt equal. Midnight and we went on till dawn, and I felt for the first time that I had given as much as received. no pity, no guilt. And I accepted. Love. Desire. Felt strong. And alive.
लाइफ में बहुत अच्छे लोगों से ही मिली और बहुत गंदे लोगों से भी मिली. बहुत कुछ है ऊपर की सुंदरता, लोग उसी को देख के एकदम से रिस्पॉन्स करते हैं. बट गॉड ने कहीं मुझे दिया है, शायद कुछ अट्रैक्शन है क्या, आई डोंट नो. लड़के लोग भी मुझे प्रेफर करते हैं, पसंद करते हैं, बात करना. समटाइम्स वो घूमने फिरने की बातें करते हैं, मुझसे मिलते भी हैं, मिलने के बाद भी बोल देते हैं, कमिटमेंट भी करते हैं. हाँ ठीक है, हम घर में डिस्कस करके बताते हैं. तो घर में डिस्कस करना, मुझसे पर्सनली मिलना, सो डिफरेंट. कई लोग मुझे वैसे मिले हैं, दे आर सेइंग कि कांति इफ यू आर डूइंग फॉर मी सो एंड सो देन आई गिव यू द हेल्प इन दिस रिगार्ड्स एंड सो. Thank you so much. I'm okay with my help. But this is my problem. I don't need anything. दो रोटी कमाती हूँ, दो रोटी खाती हूँ. मुझे किसी भी इंडिपेंडेंट नहीं हूँ. अभी तक मैंने यही देखा. पहले तो लगता था कि टाइम निकल जाएगा ऐसे, तो अब तो एज आ रही है उस हिसाब से लग रहा है कि नहीं, somebody is in होना चाहिए लाइफ के अंदर जिसके साथ दुख सुख सब डेली रूटीन्स की बातें कर सके. टू थाउजेंड सेवन में हमने एडवर्टाइजमेंट दिया न्यूज़ पेपर में फॉर मैट्रिमोनियल्स. फिर से भी गंदे गंदे केसेस लेकर आते थे पापा. नहीं इतनी ज़्यादा डिफॉर्मिटी नहीं है मेरे अंदर, तो ऑलवेज आई एम रिफ्यूजिंग. मैं भी राजकुमारी नहीं हूँ तो एक्सेप्ट नहीं करती राजकुमार हूँ, ठीक है. बट वो ऐसा बॉय हो जो मुझे अंडरस्टैंड करे, उसको फील ना हो कि मैं ऐसी लड़की के साथ जा रहा हूँ जिसको डिफॉर्मिटी है. जैसे गलती हो गई तुम्हें मैंने चूज़ किया, ऐसा ना कोई बोले. थोड़ा सा पढ़ा लिखा हूँ, हैप्पी लाइफ जीने की इच्छा रखता हूँ. जिस चीज़ से मैं आगे बढ़ी हूँ उस चीज़ के लिए ना प्यार से रहूँ. बहुत कुछ चेंज कर भी सकती हूँ मैं, बट नॉट एवरीथिंग. मेरी अपनी भी तो लाइफ है, मुझे अपने मैं उसको उनको एक्सपेक्ट नहीं करती कि तुम सारा चेंज हो जाओ, उसको नहीं करूँगी ना मैं. तो वो भी नहीं एक्सपेक्ट करे मुझसे कि ना अपने उसके सारा कुछ चेंज हो जाऊँ, ठीक है ना. जैसी हूँ मैं वैसी ही रहूँगी.
When did Yogesh come to Bombay? And was that?
Twice.
होटल याद है जो वही था?
दो होटल था, एक तो तुमने मेरे साथ बुक कराया था that Udupi one, Udupi के साथ में जो था लॉन्च. And once it was mother.
यशोदा तुमको छोड़ने गई थी
यार. यशोदा के साथ हम स्टेशन पे गए थे. And we जहाँ पे लोकल ट्रेन का वो है ना बांद्रा में, we kept waiting, अरे ट्रेन ही नहीं आ रही, ट्रेन लेट हो गई. And we were calling Yogesh, he said ट्रेन तो आ गई, नहीं नहीं यार कहीं नहीं है.
Whatever. Flirting or proposals I've only received except one, I think, yes. I've only received from other people who are savagely challenged, because maybe there, you know, you are at an equal footing or whatever. So that's one area I've always thought about. I've had crushes on a lot of people, but I've not had the courage, you know. What if they turn me away? with people who can see, maybe you get dependent on them slightly. I would take it negatively. Like, it shouldn't be sympathy, it should be true feeling, right? Now I'm married. I've been married for slightly over 2 years. He too was a part of NAB. I knew him since more or less, I don't know, class 5 or 6 or something. We got more time to get together during, like, when we both were in college. Usually, like, we try to squeeze in some weekend vacations to just get away from all this, from our schedules and from work and from everything. Once in a while you want to go out, it could be just like as simple as just, you know, a dinner. Okay, ordering food from outside and then watching movie into late night at home itself. You know, we can't just say, okay, fine, we want to go on a very romantic outing to Switzerland or to Kashmir on our own. But there are other things which you can do. It's not compromise, it's just compensating. There's no adjustment, compromises, or, you know, dissatisfaction in terms of those aspects. I think as long as the emotional bonding is there, I don't think so there's anything called extra in any sort of relationship.
June 5th. Moody skies with a bit of sunlight. I woke up, my heart racing from that amazing dream. It had been a while since I'd felt it. But how could I feel this way? Life hadn't been the same since my spinal cord injury. I didn't have sensation below my waist. Or so I thought. I couldn't possibly be aroused. Or could I? Oh yes! Yes, I could! It feels good to be back.
टेल्स मी कि हम तब तक छोटे थे ना तो हमें शीशे में अपने आप को विदाउट क्लोथ्स देखना भी अलाउड नहीं था. दे डोंट बिलीव इन सेल्फ स्टिमुलेशन. देर आर लॉट ऑफ मिथ्स कनेक्टेड विद दैट दैट इट इज नॉट गुड फॉर द बॉडी, लाइक दैट इज हार्मफुल, इट कैन गिव यू सर्टन डिजीजेस. बट आई थिंक दैट गिव्स अस अ फीलिंग ऑफ वेल बींग, happiness. So I think there is no harm. In silent and subtle voices, I have faced rejection, not because of my deformed body, but because of my functionality limitation. Dar hota hai, matlab ki shayad ye wo kaam nahi kar sake jo baki aurte kar sakti hai. Shayad ye mere saath hill stations par ghoomne na ja sake. शायद ये मेरे साथ बीचेस पर वॉक ना कर सके. शी माइट नॉट बी अ मदर. देर आर मैनी डिसबिलिटीज लाइक स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंजरी एंड ऑल. सेक्शुअल फंक्शनैलिटी इज रिड्यूस्ड, बट हैविंग अ सेक्शुअल सेटिस्फैक्शन डजंट ऑलवेज अगेन मीन एन इंटरकोर्स. इट कैन बी अ जेंटल टच विच कैन सेटिस्फाई यू. It can be just putting your head on the shoulder of your partner and sitting for long hours and just watching a movie or just watching rains. that can give you mental satisfaction. Sex is what it gives us, mental satisfaction. The stimulation starts in mind and the relaxation ends in mind. Body is in between. So it depends how we perceive, how we think about certain things.
At this point about, I mean, parenthood, because it's just been over 2 years, I guess. It's not like something we won't have. It's not like right now. It's not in our agenda, if you want to put it that way. I don't think so. I mean, there should be any difference, you know. It's any two people and the relationship, if the emotional aspect is same, why would the sexual one be different? Yeah, maybe you could say that, say, if I am, say, if I can't see, you know, and it, this is not the about the intimate sexual relationship per se, but like, say, if I'm going out, if both of us are going out, it's so we would maybe prefer more of physical contact in lieu of eye contact, since we can't have any. So maybe we would like to hold hands more often. Maybe you can take that, you can consider that. But I don't think so there should be any other, say, there's any marked difference.
आपको लगता है कि एक एक औरत को sexual feelings होने का हक है?
बिल्कुल है. एक्चुअली दिल तो सबके पास सेम ही होते हैं, जैसा होता तो उससे कोई फ़र्क नहीं पड़ता. अगर आप डिफॉर्म हैं, डिफॉर्मिटी हैं, डिसेबल हैं, तो उस चीज़ में कोई फ़र्क आता है? सेम ही होता है सबके लिए. पहले मैं बहुत डरती थी, ये चीज़ मेरे लिए नहीं है, लोग क्या कहेंगे, लोग क्या सोचेंगे, कैसे मैं बन के जा रही हूँ, अच्छे ऐसे मैं पीवीआर में घूम रही हूँ या सिलेक्ट सिटी मॉल में जा रही हूँ, तो लोगों का क्या व्यूज़ होगा मेरी तरफ, कि लड़की को चैन नहीं है, आराम नहीं है, डिफॉर्मिटी होते हुए, डिसेबल होते हुए भी इतना मूव कर रही है. सो लोग क्या सोचेंगे, लोगों का काम है कहना, लोग तो कुछ ना कुछ कहेंगे हमेशा और कहते आए. ठीक है, अगर तुम चार दीवारी में भी बैठे हो ना, तभी भी लोग कहेंगे ये लड़की तो हमेशा आप यहाँ पर ऐसा करती है, फिर भी कहेंगे. अगर तुम ज़्यादा घूम रहे हो, फिर भी लोग कह देते हैं आपको तो संडे भी आराम नहीं है मैडम.
Everybody has an impression of what you should be. You are supposed to be heterosexual. You are supposed to be, like, you are supposed to want to get married definitely by the time you're in your 20. You are supposed to be, have a perfectly working body. There are some days when I just feel like a guy. And I think, why do I have to characterize it to be masculine or be feminine? Like, sometimes I walk like a man also. Sometimes I walk like a woman. And sometimes my friends are like, oh, you're walking like a dada today. And I'm like, okay. Because before I was uncomfortable with it, before I thought, why should I always sit like this? And I should cover my mouth when I laugh. Because that's what I was told, not by my parents. My parents don't care about this thing. But a lot by my friend, that you should show your mouth, you should cross your legs, she's just like a lady. But whenever I try to conform to that, I really tried. And it felt so unnatural. And third, that after a while, I Tara Kultini. Okay, am I a man? Do I need to sit like a man? So sat like a man for a few days. And then I was like, you know what? I don't have to be anything. So I just look and be who I want to be at the moment. And that's the best.
धड़कनों में बसती हूँ ख्यालों में सजती हूँ कभी बादल बन अंबर से कभी जाम बन पैमानों से छलकती हूँ कभी तन की प्यास कभी मन की अगन हूँ कभी आंसुओं का सैलाब कभी जिस्म की जलन हूँ मैं वादे बन टूटती हूँ यादें बन तोड़ती हूँ दर्द बन दिलों को कचोटती हूँ मैं कभी अर्धांगिनी कभी संगनी हूँ मैं मीत हूँ सखा हूँ कभी बंदनी हूँ मैं कभी खुदा का नूर कभी महताब हूँ मैं मोहब्बत हूँ हाँ मोहब्बत हूँ मैं
She's the one that makes you feel like you're in love. Well, she's an indecent girl. Well, she's got a lot to say, but Clarabelle's gotta wait another day. Well, she's an indecent girl. Well, Clarabelle says she's going away. She don't need nobody else to tell her she's gonna get away. Clarabella says she's not the one. She's gonna be gone, yeah, she's gonna be gone. Well, Clarabella, she's the money maker, she's the Clarabella. She's just getting into her world. Clarabella, she's the money maker. She's an indecent girl. She's an indecent girl. Well, boss is blue. He's alone. Well, he's all alone, cause Clarabella's gone and she's gone with the wind. Well, Boss's Bill, he's all alone. He's alone just cause Clarabella's gone. Boss's Bill says he's not the one. He's gonna be there, yes, he's gonna be wow. Clarabella, she's the money maker, she's a Clarabella, she's just getting into her world. Clarabella, she's the money maker, she's an indecent girl. Well, she's an indecent girl.